ياسين والقرآن الحكيم.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى. أما بعد, the last two verses of Surah Yasin is what we discussed today, and the second last verse is where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says إنما أمره. Indeed, the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is such that إذا أراد شيئا, when Allah intends anything, when Allah desires anything, when Allah wills anything, then how does it come into effect? أن يقول له كن فيكون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to it, be, and automatically it is there. Now, many of the mufassirin say وَأَمْرُهُ بَيْنَ الْكَافِ وَالنُّونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not even dependent on saying the words kun. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala just wills for something, and without doubt, it is automatically there. Now, under this ayah, Ibn Kathir rahimullah has mentioned an incident that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that there was a person who told his children on his deathbed, he said, when I die, then burn my body and take the ashes and throw half of it into the ocean, and the other half, throw it into the desert on a very windy day. So this was obviously prior to the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And at this time, when this person had passed away, his children had done this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the akhirah, all that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had to do was kun. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said be, and the man came back alive. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked him, why did you do that? Why did you ask for your body to be burnt and all the ashes be thrown all over the show? This person said, oh Allah, I was so afraid of coming before you, that is why I told them to do that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, looking at the sincerity of this man, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave him. Yes, it is not permissible for us to cremate ourselves. This is an example of one of the previous people, when Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave us an example to explain to us what is the power of Allah. Kun fayakun. Allah says be, and automatically it comes into existence. Now, like that, when we talk about the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no matter what a person has done, it is so simple for Allah to forgive a person. If it is so simple for Allah to create the whole world where the words of kun, how simple isn't it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us? And then the last verse, فَسُبْحَانَ الَّذِي بِيَدِهِ مَلَكُوتُ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. Pure is that being in whose hands lie the reins of everything. وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. And to that same Allah, you will all return. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us about the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that Allah is in charge of everything. Allah holds the reins to everything. And the last words, وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. And you will all return to that same Allah. Returning to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is something that all of us will do. This is something that all of us will have to experience in this world. We will all go through the process of death. We will return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make that the best moments of our life. May Allah make it an occasion when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is happy with us, in a condition that we leave the words with the kalima la ilaha illallah on our tongues. May our death come upon us when we return into Allah in a condition that we are in Madinatul Munawwara. We are on the Rawdatul Mubarak. And our janazah salahs are read in Masjid al-Nabawi. And our janazahs, our bodies are then buried in Jannatul Baqi. That is what every single person desires, a death in a beautiful way. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us at the end of the surah. It is also at this time, وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. Many of us have got those who have left the world already, those who have already gone to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this should remind us about them as well, that those people are gone, that doesn't mean they should be out of our minds. Those who have gone, they can still be benefited. And a simple example is the hadith of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that what benefits a person after he leaves the world, his children that make dua for him. And it is on this occasion that I requested du'as for my father who had passed away. And this is something that reminds us, وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. When you return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we should remember all of those who have passed away and all of those who have gone back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah grant him the highest abodes of Jannah. As children, this is the best that we can do, is making dua for those who have passed away. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept this little effort. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it such that now when we recite Surah Yasin, we recite it with meaning, we recite it with love, and we recite it in such a way that it brings us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you for taking the effort of learning the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this a means of us coming closer to Him. We will recite the last few verses of the surah and then conclude inshallah, requesting your du'as for all of us, our families, our friends. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from all of you and bless you and remove this difficulty from the entire world. May Allah accept all of your du'as and all of your ibadah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أوليس الذي خلق السماوات والأرض بقادر على أن يخلق مثلهم بلى وهو الخلاق العليم إنما أمره إذا أراد شيئا أن يقول له كن فيكون فسبحان الذي بيده ملكوت كل شيء وإليه ترجعون.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept, may Allah forgive all of us, our families, those who have passed away, our ustad, all of our asatida, our mashayikh. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive the entire ummah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.